Hi, good morning. That suspect is in custody. They took him to the hospital just out of precaution, but I'll step aside. You can see the SWAT team is just clearing out of this area, but the investigation is going to be far from over. It was quite a morning. Let's start where it all began in downtown Los Angeles. Right around midnight, officers from LAPD were in the area, and they say that they heard shots fired. Now, it's hard when you're in downtown Los Angeles to determine where that gunfire was coming from because the sound can ricochet off of those buildings, but they saw a vehicle leaving that area without its headlights. It was a black sedan, and when officers approached that vehicle, that is when the pursuit began. Now, while officers were in pursuit of that sedan, which, by the way, that pursuit went through downtown Los Angeles, South LA, the 105, the 405, officers from LAPD in the downtown area discovered a shooting victim. That victim was taken to a hospital where that victim later died. Now back to the suspect. That suspect led officers all the way here to the Delray area, exiting off of the 90 right in the Culver City area, meandered down some surface streets, hit a parked car, and then the suspect who was driving fled on foot. In the meantime, there was another person inside of that suspect's vehicle in the passenger side. We understand that person sustained a gunshot injury. That person, too, who's now considered a suspect, was taken to an area hospital listed in stable condition. Our suspect entered a home on Braddock. He broke through a window, got inside. There were as many as three residents at home at the time. Now, the LAPD airship had been following all of this, so they knew which house the guy was going into. They saw the guy grab guns out of the car. Officers who were on the ground used their loudspeakers to tell the residents to get out. They did so, and then that barricade situation, which lasted for five full hours, finally coming to an end.
Once they determined that the suspect was inside and refused to come out, they determined that they would use gas and introduce it into the residence. There was no communication at all with SWAT officers at scene, and the only time they had any communication with him is when he signaled to them and told them he was coming out. We always hope for our SWAT resources to bring these things to a peaceful conclusion, and this time they in fact did.
So again, that suspect is in custody, possibly wanted for a whole host of charges, including possibly murder. We'll keep you updated as this investigation unfolds. One other thing, they believe that suspect vehicle was also involved in a carjacking. We'll have much more coming up, but for right now, that is the very latest here in Delray. I'm Wendy Burch, and I'll send it back to you.